When the Adhan was instructed by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know the wording, we have it to this day. Bilal ibn Rabah was the one who was called upon to climb up a certain place, a rooftop. And he was told, you call out the Adhan because your voice is clearer and better and it has a sweetness in it. So Bilal ibn Rabah got up and he called out the Adhan. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. To this day we hear it, may Allah grant us goodness. And he became known as the Mu'addin of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he had an assistant. His assistant was known as Abdullah ibn Ummi Maktum radiallahu anhu, and we've already spoken about him. Bilal ibn Rabah radiallahu anhu, the conquest of Makkah came in, and three people entered the Kaaba with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam: Uthman ibn Talha, Usama bin Zayd, and Bilal ibn Rabah radiallahu anhu. And the kuffar, the leaders of Makkah, were watching, they were looking. Wow, that slave from Africa is the main man with Muhammad today, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We can't believe this. Some of them were still non-Muslim, so they said, luckily my father died before he saw this day. The other man says, I can't really digest what I'm seeing here. I don't know what's wrong with these people. Are these the same people whom we drove out of their homes? Today they have come back here with thousands of men. And look at this man, he's a black African, straight from Africa, and he's one of the most important people. And he is standing here in the Kaaba, one of four, top four, subhanallah. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Bilal, Bilal, it's the time for prayer. Climb right on top of the Kaaba and call out the Adhan. For the first time, Bilal ibn Rabah got on top of the Kaaba, and the kuffar of Quraysh are watching. Abu Sufyan is watching. He had just accepted Islam, but the others who were still not Muslim are watching. And Bilal ibn Rabah says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And the guys are shocked. Wow, you mean this man? And people started commenting. So Abu Sufyan says, I'm not commenting because you know the grains of sand in front of me will inform Muhammad what we are talking about. So you guys better keep quiet. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came out of the Kaaba and told them, I heard what you were saying. I've been told. So Abu Sufyan says, didn't I tell you? The two of them who were there immediately declared, you are a messenger of Allah. At the time of the death of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the body was not yet buried. The blessed body of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not yet buried. And the time of Salah came in. So Bilal ibn Rabah had got up in order to call the Adhan. And he started calling the Adhan. And when he got to, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. He was unable to utter those words. He stopped. He choked. He cried. And all the companions burst out crying. Here is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We bear witness that he is the messenger. Bilal ibn Rabah, the most beautiful voice, the voice that when people heard it, they wanted to come for prayer. He could not say this anymore because he was so much in love with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, I was a slave boy and I used to be so engrossed in my thoughts. Islam came and saved me and made me from amongst the most noble and honored. And here I am. The man who came with the message, I am calling out his name. He just choked. He couldn't carry on. So at the time of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, Bilal ibn Rabah excused himself. He says, Ya Abu Bakr, I cannot call this Adhan out. A few days he tried. Every time he would cry and break down profusely when he got to Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. So what happened, Bilal? According to some narrations, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu allowed him, excused him. He went up to Ash-Sham, he went up to the Palestinian region, and he passed away. He is buried in Dimashq. But at the same time, there are two things that we need to know about Bilal ibn Rabah radiallahu anhu. In the 15th year of Hijrah, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu came up in order to get the keys of Jerusalem. And what happened? The Sahaba radiallahu anhu told him, convince Bilal. He has never called Adhan after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Convince him to call the Adhan. So Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu told him, you know, you are our leader and you have been freed by our leader Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. We'd like you to call the Adhan out once. They convinced him. He got up to call the Adhan. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And they burst out crying. Because it brought back memories of Medina, Munawwara. Memories of the days of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Bilal ibn Rabah, the Mu'addin of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first time after so many years in the presence of Umar ibn al-Khattab, he calls out the Adhan in Ash-Sham, and it was something that shook them, their hair stood, and they really wept so much, they cried, subhanallah.